It's not your turn, bear. Do not be sorry. Be better.
I combed the vault, so someone got there first and stole your essence.
Magog! The thief could be anywhere by now. Failure was inevitable. We're done. Finished. Good night.
What'll I tell Aphrodite?
Tell her I'm on my way to be flattened on a chariot track.
Can't even cross the road, can he?
Okay, you got it.
Wait!
This is a long shot, but we could track the thief via Amazon. As in my daughters, the Amazons. Uncanny trackers with uncanny tracking devices.
My God!
I could do it!
Don't get too excited. They aren't talking to me right now. It's a long story. But I do have an Amazon tracking kit I received as an offering. It's in my fortress, which Typhon has locked me out of. Gods, this is pointless. Like my dad says, I'm just a bird brain. Unless...
Unless?
A blast of my salpings could open the gate. I didn't want Typhon's tentacles on it, so I hid it.
Your salpings, huh? I'll have to think of something to play.
Who do you think you are, Aphrodite? You can't toot an instrument of war willy-nilly. Besides, that's only half the job. You'll have to open the gate with Typhon's melody of tribute.
Oh, really? What's the melody?
Typhon's no normal narcissist. He forced Pan to dedicate a song to him and trained my gate to respond to it alone. Pan toiled on the music in a vault somewhere. That's your best bet to find the melody. Once you've got everything, if you make it out alive, play at the fortress gate to open it.
Hey, where's my tribute melody?
I think it's the burps people get after drinking too much wine.
If fighting in wars wasn't so lucrative, I could have been one clucking good Salpinx player.
Ares on the Salpinx was an act of war.
Yeah.
Encryption's music? Could be a piece of Typhon's tribute melody. A part of Typhon's tribute melody. Ha! I think Typhon's tribute is complete.
He should have hired Apollo instead. He charges less than Pan anyway. This thing looks straight from the underworld. How the Hades did it end up here?
Fenyx had weathered the storm of Typhon's rage. For them. The Dracon Ismenius was a child of Ares and the protector of his realm.
Didn't that thing die in Thebes? Yes, I remember, because he used to bring that little monster to dinner parties. And then finally, one year, just like that, no more hissing.
He brought its body to the Golden Isle to mourn his loss.
That doesn't sound like Ares.
There's a lot about him you do not know.
What happened to its teeth?
They were knocked out by Cadmos, a famous beast slayer, and later Jason of the Argonauts. Whenever the Dracon's teeth are planted in the earth, a soldier sprouts from the ground.
Dental warfare!
Typhon corrupted these soldiers and created an evil army of his own.
I don't understand. Why didn't Ares tell me he'd brought the snake's body here?
You aren't exactly the easiest person to talk to.
Sure, I joke around.
At his expense?
I'm breaking the ice.
You're making the ice. Bury the Dracon's teeth, and perhaps your words will grow to comfort your son. Or even found a city, the way the Spartoi helped Cadmos found Thebes. And there, in the jaws of the once mighty serpent, was Ares's instrument of war.
It's always the last place you look, isn't it?
Okay, got Ares's Salpinks and Typhon's tribute melody. Time to go open the fortress.